£4.99 plus VAT. It would have cost us for a smoke machine tonight. Quid. So, ladies and gentlemen, what an absolute pleasure it is to be here and see so many of you reaching out for counselling. For being here as part of my first ever UK bereavement tour. Ladies and gentlemen, give yourselves an absolutely thunderous round of applause. Sorry, I didn't realise that would choke you up at the beginning. I didn't see your coffin. I apologise. But I guess we can turn it around, love, because I guess it's only when we realise we're dying do we truly wake up and start learning how to live. Now, for those who don't know me, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Morgan Bennett, number one 24-hour pets bereavement counsellor. I specialise in a very unique kind of pet loss. You probably already guessed it, that's right. Rabbit bereavement. If you've lost a dog, a cat, a horse, I'm sorry. I can't help you. You should have lost a rabbit. Now, I know what you're thinking, to do a rebrand, especially you, but I'm coming to you in a little bit. You're thinking, you're not English, are you, Morgan? No, I'm not English, I'm African. Born in Barnsley, raised in Africa. If you have lost a rabbit, the chances are your happiness up to this point in life has not been great. And I can prove it. So ladies and gentlemen, at Bethnal Green, put your hand up if you've ever lost a rabbit. Okay, there you go. You're very brave, you're very brave. Okay. And give us a cheer if you didn't have a rabbit. Notice how much happier the people that didn't have rabbits are. Now, before I help you, it's important that you trust me. So I'm going to share a little of my story with you. When I was around 8 months years old, I was found on a landfill site by a man in a digger. He found me inside a microwave being suckled by rabbits. I was taken to an orphanage and adopted by Botswanan parents who were on a gap year in Barnsley. They took me back to the motherland and raised me as their own. In the Okavango Delta, the Kalahari, on the rolling grasslands of the savannah. My African mother, Mary Bemmy, was able to breastfeed. So I got all my nutrients sucking on the teats of lactating rabbits. Over the years, I drank gallons of the milk and naturally acquired many of their skills and characteristics. A very high libido. Yay! Fecal pellets. And that woman stared into the headlights of oncoming traffic. I grew up surrounded by rabbits. I learned to live like and walk like and talk like and. That means I'm doing not bad, not been up to, not a lot, just much old tweets. So, very similar to Welsh. They taught me many secrets of the animal kingdom. Opposable thumbs in under their paws. Yes. Have you got a dog? Dog. 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 Yeah, dad. Like I say, I do remind. Lurcher. Springer Spaniel. Yes, Springer Spaniel. Okay, second one, that's not bad, is it? look tonight. Go back, have a look. You'll look, won't you? But you won't find him. It's because they're rigging him. I've seen Alsatians making curtains on a sewing machine. In your life, you have lost a rabbit.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I know you have lost, that's why you're here. Okay. And that's why you're here, is that it? Now, if you don't mind me asking, what's your name?
Jenny.
Hello, Jenny. Everyone say hello, Jenny.
Hello, Jenny.
And what was the name of your rabbit, please, Jenny?
Well, I had seven.
Who's your favourite one?
The
trap
one.
The trap, no, we'll do all of them.
Trixie.
Okay, I'm feeling that. Okay. If you don't mind me asking, how did Trixie shuffle off his mortal coil?
Fell on it and popped it.
You fell on it and you popped it. Okay.
Well,
anyway, okay, so. And then, how long ago did you lose Trixie?
I was 9.
You were 9, so roughly how many years ago?
12.
About
25
years. So still very raw. Now, before I help you, okay, we're going to go on a little journey. Okay? And I'm not going to stand here and go, I'm going to cure your grief, you know. We'll chip away a bit of the grouting, but maybe later on, when we do a one-to-one, we can knock down the old wall, all right? Okay. Now, before I go on a little journey at Freedom England, I need to key into your mind, okay? Now, just remind me of your name again, please, Laura.
Jenny.
I forgot because, again, pop. Into your mind, okay? And I'm gonna come inside you, okay? Okay? So I want you to really look at me, okay? If you've eaten a nice piece of homemade cake, perhaps with a lovely thick layer of rich buttercream icing, and you thought, ooh, I like this cake. You haven't, yeah? Okay? You ever thought to yourself, Jenny, I might even have myself another slice? Greedy. What's your favourite type of cake?
Coffee cake.
Okay, Jenny, think about where we are. Okay. What's your second favourite type of cake?
Lemon cheese.
Look at me, Jenny.
Lemon cheese.
You can look awful, babe. Hot stuff up there. What's your third favourite type of cake, Jenny? Carrot cake, there we go. This is just for you, Jenny. Okay? Everyone else is going to go along with it, okay? We're going to help Jenny tonight, aren't we? Let me say hi. Hi. Yes, Jenny, here we go. I want you to think of a number between 1 and 9. Okay? Take that number and multiply it by 9.
Oh, God. Oh,
that's every time, though, haven't it? Multiply it times. You got a number with a single digit in there, just hold it in your head. You got a number with two digits in, just add them together, okay?
Hang on. Yeah.
-4.
Oh, God. Yeah.
Okay. Now, see that number up in the sky in the metaphorical fridge, put it on ice. Now, what do you think of your second favourite pope? Not your third, not your fourth, not your fifth. It's not your second favourite, okay? So you can have like Clement the 10th or Gregory the 14th or Pope Benedictus the 9th, whatever. It's just got to be your second favourite. Take the number of that pole, now it's your other side of the bridge, okay? Okay, you're going to go a little trip now to Sierra Leone. And you're going to go by sea. And you're going to go on an aquatic vessel, but don't tell me what vessel you're going on. I want you to see yourself on that vessel now driving. Do that for me, Jenny. I say, sea spray in your face, mahogany dashboard, neck shoes, flip flops, crocs, the football. Roxy Reddy. Now, you're going to go with a member of your family, Jenny, okay? But don't tell what member of the family you're going to go with, okay? Now, they whisper a very personal secret into your ear. They tell you they've got diabetes. Now, we all know there are two types of diabetes, Jenny. I want to think the type of diabetes you're thinking of, Jenny. An attitude on the side of the fridge in the sky. Now, you're about 20 metres from shore, you can't get in because there's docks. There's rocks. There's rocks in the docks, okay? So what you do is you get a little tightrope, an anchor on the end, you swing it across, okay? And you start doing the tightrope, you're okay, you're going to do that for a jet. There you go. You're feeling great. You're feeling like a brand new washcloth. Fresh out of the packet. Shag of leather. You step foot onto shore in Sierra Leone, and unbeknownst to you, Jenny, you got a banjo tied behind your back. How many strings on that banjo? Shoosh! Yes. There you go. Take the normal strings on that banjo, and add it to your number sat in the fridge in the sky. You're on shore in Sierra Leone. You've got a crowd around you, Jenny. Of course you have. Why? Because I anticipated in the presence of a genius, okay? And you can hit your banjo and you can start screwing away, okay? Start screwing away the banjo, Jenny. Okay, there we go. I'm going to sing a little song. You're all going to join in, aren't you? And you say, aye. Ah. There you go, ready? Peter Rabbit's got to fly upon his nose.
Peter Rabbit's got to fly upon his nose.
Why aren't you singing? Now, you've just been hit very hard in the mouth by a golf ball, okay? You're all having damage, but you are extremely winded, Jenna, okay? So in a few moments, okay, you're going to retch up that ball and you're going to catch it, okay? We're all going to help a retch out, let me say aye.
Aye.
Here we go, so start retching. Why aren't you retching? In your hand is a golf ball, okay? And on that golf ball is a number. Now, would you be impressed, Jenny, if not only the number on that golf ball was written on a piece of paper inside the envelope inside my pocket?
I can well
impress. But! Also, the type of aquatic vessel we went to Sierra Leone in was also written on a piece of paper inside the envelope inside my pocket. Would you be impressed, Jenny?
Well impressed.
Would anyone else be impressed? Let me say aye!
Aye!
The number on that golf ball, okay? Just through the air. That's it. Step off of the number. Don't ask him. That's it. Okay? That's it. And underneath now, the tap of aquatic vessel you went to Sierra Leone.
Let me just strike him, please.
Don't strike. Full stop. Jenny, please share with the audience, with the audience of Bethnal Brothers. First of all, the number on that golf ball, please, love. 13. Okay. And now the type of aquatic vessel you went to. Don't put yourself down, Jenny. 13, did you? Okay. Good answer. Correct answer was, of course, Jenny. come to the lodge that matters, don't it?
Yeah.
Stopping off for a meat pie at the services, you know. Don't matter if it costs £6. You make up, I get a tooth, one of the camping chair, and a magpie. Whining out my window, trying to throw an apple car in the bin. It don't matter if you don't get it in. It's biodegradable. A little crow that lets you have it. It used to become part of the food chain. Circle of life. Full of potato. Look at the journey you just took. You went all the way to East Africa in a dinghy. Who'd you go with? Who'd you go with? Your brother, lovely, that's all you need to match. Do you like maths?
No.
No? But you made it fun, didn't you, Jenny? You know, you played the banjo, you made the locals happy. I mean, you didn't know this, but you nearly killed one little girl with a bowler. And unfortunately, she didn't make it, but for the last 45 minutes of her life, you gave her a hope with a banjo. So, you know, but problems, you've all got problems, haven't we? Let me just say aye. My wife, Jub, she lost half her leg last year. She tripped on a paving slab and got sucked in, roller bushes down the car wash, you know. I had that thing that Stephen Hawking has got, but I got over it. I don't focus on that, Jenny. I focus on the moment in life, the moments in life on my journey that took me breath away. You know, like when I saw a camel dancing in a technical burka. In the Afghan stage adaptation of Joseph. I've seen a goth licking a calippo. I've seen a man cover his entire naked body in wrist papers. Took about half hour. Jump off a bridge shouting, I'm a dove. but you weren't a dove, was it? He was an aerodynamic called Kyle Barrett. I don't focus on that bit, I focus on the nice bit, the rizzle bit, you know, the bit when he hit the ground, the aftermath, it was like confetti at a wedding. Problems, we've all got problems, you know. Well, life, you don't focus on the bad bits, you know, it's a mirror of confusion as it is. I once knew a man called Michael Finnegan. And he had alopecia from the neck up, but I don't try and work it out, I just accept it, you know. Coconuts, they're nice, aren't they?
Yeah.
But the word don't make sense, does it? Cocoa, what's cocoa?
Chocolate.
Is there any chocolates out of all of them? No, there ain't. Nuts, are there any nuts inside a coconut?
No.
No, there ain't. Chocolate and nuts, that's a Snickers, not a Bounty. But... You had 25 good years with Trixie. Don't cry because it's over. Smile, Jenny, because it happened, love. All right? Thank you very much. Okay. ping this elastic band, which you're going to keep round your wrist. And every time the thought comes in, the unsavory thought, which it will, okay, I just want you to ping the band and in your head just say, Morgan's Mary. Morgan's Mary. So if you don't mind me asking, last bit tonight, could you all please put your hands together? We're not clapping! We're praying! These are words. To be honest, I don't know if you're down pep, so ruin that bit for me. Jenny, we'll talk after the show, okay? And we'll go back one to one. Ladies and gentlemen, have the Morgan Mary.